Good Saturday, everybody. Jewel here with you with the tropical update. Let's get started. Got some things to go over right quick. Of course, the remnants of Laura now. The winds are 25 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure is 1,004 millibars. It's located 38.4 north, 83.3 west. It's moving east at 28 miles per hour. And this combining with a cold front that's right above it, actually, they're going to meet up. That's why there's severe weather all the way up and down these areas today in the general forecast. If you haven't checked that out, please do so. Now, we have disturbance number one. It's still a tropical wave, folks. It's about 550 miles east of the Windward Islands. It's disorganized in its shower activity and thundershower activity. Now, some gradual development of the system is possible during the next several days while it moves westward at about 15 miles per hour toward the Lesser Antilles. Now, regardless of development, this system will likely be producing some gusty winds and locally heavy rainfall across portions of the Windward and Leeward Islands Sunday, tomorrow. Now, it's got a 20% chance of forming in 2 days, 30% chance in 5 days. Remember what this said, 2 days and 5 days. Whenever it's going over the island area here, you guys will get some rain out of it. You guys will get some gusty winds. It might get a little breezy, but at this point in time, it's nothing that you can't handle or are used to. That's what it's looking like to me right now. You see it's pointed over this way. I think it's going to go over this way, then try to form right around in here. Then it will move up, still trying to form some, come up this area. Don't get scared yet, folks, for the Gulf. Come up across, go in the Gulf right around in this area, but I think it's going to track westerly and go across Mexico. Remember, all of this can change. It's just what it's looking like to me right now from all of the information and models that I have gone over. Now, when we come, this pesky little stuff won't stop, will it? When we come over to disturbance number two, it's still a tropical wave. It's located over the eastern Atlantic, just southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands, and this system is expected to move very slowly for the next several days. Now, some development is possible early next week over the eastern and central tropical Atlantic. Now, the National Hurricane Center this morning is showing a 40% chance of forming in 5 days, zero in 2 days, but I have found some other things that say it may have a 52% chance, but they would still probably categorize it as a 40% chance from the National Hurricane Center. Looking at the satellite image, and I got this from Tropical Tidbits this morning instead of having to jump through many hoops just to get it up. And thank you, Levi, for sharing this with us. Now, as you can see, here are the islands right in here. Here's a system. See how disorganized it looks? Yes, there will be some heavy rain in it as it goes across the islands, as I said. I do not think the wind's going to be that bad. You will get some gust, but once again, it shouldn't be anything that you cannot handle at this time. Now, we also have this disturbance right in here. This is the one they're given the chance to form. This one over here just coming off the coast. This is a mess, folks. I'll leave it at that. We're going to have to watch this very, very carefully as the days go by. Now, you can see we do have where it's lighter. That's a little bit of a dry air mixed in together. But you can see out in these areas, especially in the Caribbean, there's nothing going on to stop anything, okay? Nothing going on to stop anything. And as the days pass, this Saharan dry air and the shear will loosen up and become less and less as the days go by. As we are almost to, starting the first week of September, the peak of hurricane season. I do want to point out to everyone, I've showed this in years past, I want to show it again just to remind everyone where the most likely paths of storms in September go. And that is in the orange areas, as you can see. They do still come up in the Gulf. They still go towards Mexico. As I pointed out, I thought that disturbance number one will probably kind of take this path exactly, as a matter of fact. As it looks now, it could change. And, of course, they still go up into areas of Mississippi, Alabama, Louisiana, across Florida, and then up the North Carolina coast and out. And then they come in, they'll go to Florida. They can go anywhere up and down this seaboard, the eastern seaboard or the Gulf. So please be aware of this. I just wanted to show this to you at this time to make sure you've got everything ready during the peak of hurricane season. I found this and wanted to share it with you guys. I'll get back to what's going on in the tropics in just one moment, but these are some of the storms that I have been through in the past several years. I've been through many, many more than this, but these are some of the examples I want to show you. There was Bertha in 1996. Bertha was a tropical storm. You've heard me say I've got more flooding with some tropical storms than I have hurricanes. Bertha was one of them. We had flooding for at least 2 to 3 days with 2 to 3 to 4 feet of water everywhere for that long, just with Tropical Storm Bertha. Then there was Fran. Then there was Bonnie. And then there was Floyd. I will not forget Floyd. Floyd was a Category 4, but when it reached eastern North Carolina, it came in as a Category 2. What happened? We had flooding. It was awful, folks. It was awful. We had flooding for days on end. Power was out for, I think, 2 weeks with Floyd. What happened was Floyd stalled right over eastern North Carolina. Then, in 2003, there was Isabel. Now, Isabel was something, folks. Very, very damaged. Doesn't look like bad storm at all. Not really. I mean, you know, compared to the others. Isabel did so much damage in eastern North Carolina, it was unreal. So don't ever go by, you know, pretty much you can tell by the wind and the rain what you can sustain and stand where you live. But always be prepared for the very, very roughest stuff. And if it's looking too rough, please get out, okay? And then we had Irene. I won't forget Irene. Irene came across, turned around, came back, hit us again. Yes, we didn't have power for days and weeks and flooding galore. Matthew, as you see, rode the coastline. But when it got to where I was, I live right up in here, it was out to sea, about 75 to 100 miles. Now, Matthew was a Category 4. Well, it was out to sea that far. We had flooding galore. We had cranes holding up cell phone towers. It was awful. The Coast Guard helicopters right in this area, right in front of my house, riding up and down the river trying to rescue people. It was a mess. And, of course, the last one we had that we'll never forget, where you guys saw a video of me watching a house float out beside me, was Florence. Now, Florence, when she was in the ocean, she was a ways from us. She was a Category 4, too. But she came in as a Category 1, intensifying in some places to a 2. But, I mean, look at all the damage from a small hurricane. So, be aware of this stuff, folks. I'm just telling you, I've lived through these things, and it's a mess. Don't concentrate on this or that or the other. Just make sure you got your plans and your kits ready at all times. Now, as we look at the Ncep Ensemble, and exactly what does that mean? Well, it's the National Center for Environmental Prediction. That's what it means, okay? This is the TC Genesis. This is how they have come together and what they think the probabilities of these storms will be having. And as you can see, this is forecast during 120 to 140 hours out from the initial time of today. This is in the Pacific. Do not worry about this. Now, disturbance number one looking like it may, like I said, come down this way. Jamaica, you'll be safe. Okay? The islands, you're going to get some rain, some gusty winds out of it coming up within the next 24 hours. Okay? That's all. But when it does start to get any chance of forming over here at a 40% chance, it's going to be over in this area, then moving up and looking like it's going to go up and then come down around and through Mexico. That's what it's looking like now. Now, here's disturbance number two right here. It could go a lot of ways, looking like most of the tracks have it tracking westwardly. We got three tracks coming here, four tracks really. Some of them spreading out, just way too early to tell where it will go yet. But it's looking like coming up in the days, it will have a 50 to 60% chance of forming. This one isn't even off the coast of Africa yet. It's barely. This is what it's going to look like in this time period. Okay, just coming off the coast very well. But while it's on land, folks, it's a high-end tropical storm with winds and rain and everything else. That's why I keep telling you. We got to really, really, really watch this system. Okay, I'm going to turn this on, just let it roll through, and we'll look at the precipitable water totals that could occur throughout the next few hours of today into, well, it really starts out yesterday and goes into today. But you can see, as these systems move, and everybody down around in here, you can see, now here we are at today, this water is coming your way. We do have some rain coming your way. You may get around 2 inches of rain in some places around the island areas, so be aware of that. And you can also see as it tracks through all this rain and these severe storms I've told you about, and the general forecast for the eastern sections of the state down through, I'd say maybe southern New Jersey down through parts of South Carolina can occur. So yes, these rain cells are going to make up, and rain is coming along with some severe weather for this section of the U.S. possible. But you guys around the islands, as far as tropical conditions go, looking like with this little first system, once again, just some gusty and breezy winds and possibly 2 to 2.5 inches of rain. Looking at westerly wind shear and all together, you can see I have this set. I don't know if you can see it or not, but this is for 120 hours out from now as these systems should try to develop. You can see there's nothing going on here. Nothing going on here where these things are coming off Africa. There's the Cabo Verde Islands right there. There ain't nothing out here, folks, to stop these things from intensifying. That's why another reason many of them are following this pattern going just right up in this area. But you can also see that there will be a little, if disturbance number two tries to go this way, there will be this one little section where there could be 50 mile per hour wind shear. And where you see the lighter color is 30 mile per hour. So we're going to have to wait and see if it gets tangled up in this or not, which way it goes, but I'm thinking right now it might have a little problem as it's looking now. Of course, all of this can change. Now, I know a lot of you like for me to show this the European model, so I'll show this too. We just got to wait and see, though. I can't stress that enough on days from now what may come of these other systems. But for the first disturbance here, this is set for around this afternoon. You can see the islands here. This is the wind, the strongest winds looking like you're going to get. Hardly nothing, folks. 30 mile per hour wind gust. You guys can handle it, okay? You see up here where the moisture is mixing in with the cold front from the remnants of Laura and the cold front. These winds are going to be more. But let's just run it on through. We'll get up to Sunday around 2 in the morning. You can see that all of this severe chances of weather and precipitation and wind is going to be exiting the East Coast at this time. You guys are still getting rain and wind from this system here. We're going to move this up a little bit so we can get a better view of where these things may go. We'll get to Sunday around 6 p.m. This system here, you'll see right here, it's still hanging around the island area. The wind still only 30 mile per hour gust at this time. You are going to get some rain with it. Don't think you won't. You will get some rain with it. By Monday at 7 a.m., you can see it moves down. Moves a little to the west-southwest as it goes across the islands here. Looking like it shouldn't be any big deal for Puerto Rico or the Dominican Republic at this time. By 9 p.m., Monday the 31st, it does try to reform. Remember I told you it may try to reform, and the wind gusts in it now are up to 36 miles per hour. Still not a tropical storm, though. By Tuesday at 1 p.m., looks like it's trying to get its act together a little bit more. I think the wind gusts are up now to 45 miles per hour. Let's move on along and get through this. We'll get to Wednesday at 12 p.m. You can see it is moving down towards Honduras and the Nicaragua area, mostly closer to Honduras, though, right on the coastlines between them. Thursday, 11 a.m. as it moves on through. Looking like Honduras, it's just a low pressure. That's all it is, folks, just a low pressure system. You will have some gusty winds and you will get some rain as we come up to Friday at 12 p.m. Looks like it's a little bit more organized at this point, as you can see, with a little bit stronger wind gust up to 57 miles per hour. So it could turn into a tropical storm. That's by Friday as it approaches Guatemala and Honduras areas right up in here. We'll get to Saturday. You can see it goes inland. I'm doing this step by step so everybody in the Gulf will not bug out right now. You've had enough pressure on you. Not that it can't change and go up in the Gulf. It can. But it just don't look like it's going to right now. And here's the other system coming up right here. It's just a low pressure too that is showing up on National Hurricane Center site at this time. You can see now this is coming back down. It should come across and cross and get into Mexico right in here. Shouldn't be a threat to the U.S. However, this system right here, it's going to get absorbed and entangled with another low pressure is what it's looking like now. But by Sunday, the 6th of September, a week from tomorrow, this is going to be coming off the coast of Africa. And already, while it is on land, it does have 57 mile per hour winds in it. That's a lot of wind, folks. So let's move it on up to Monday. And of course, this is way far out. A lot of things can change. I'm not saying this is what's going to happen. I'm saying we need to watch this system really, really strongly each and every day. As it gets off the coast, just barely, the wind in it is 62 miles per hour. So that's a check of the tropical forecast today. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Thank you for everyone who has subscribed. Thank you for watching my videos, sharing my videos, donations you send me, anything you do for me, I appreciate it, and I thank you for it. Please click subscribe, click the bell, and make sure to check off all to ensure you get all the latest weather forecasts, severe weather updates, and tropical weather updates as they happen. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. I love you all. Thanks so much for watching.